الحمد لله الذي جعل هذه حياة الدنيا دار تكليف وفناء الحمد لله الذي جعل الآخرة دار الجزاء وبقاء وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وعد عباده المتقين بالجزاء الأوفى وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله العبد المصطفى اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارِك عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أهل البر والتقوى أما بعد عباد الله أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل فهي سبيل السعادة والفوز والنجاح في الدنيا والآخرة. My brothers and my sisters, I advise myself and then yourselves to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as He is deserved to be feared. For indeed with that taqwa, you will have bliss, happiness, fi dunya wal akhirah. You will have success and salvation with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today I remind myself and those who I am addressing regarding the reality of this world, the world that we live in, that we constantly always hear the ayat and the wahy regarding it, but we never get tired mentioning it. For indeed, that reminder benefits the believer. And before I start, there's a principle that I want you to first understand before we proceed. And we hear it all the time. فَإِنَ الْأَصْدَقَ الْكَلَامِ كَلَامَ اللَّهِ. The best speech, the most truthful speech, is the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the guidance of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. لَا يُشُكْ أَحَدٌ فِيهِمَا. There is no one that doubts that. And the reason I start with this, that what am I about to say now are not my words. It is the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So maybe the reminder from amongst ourselves may not shake the hearts. But know that it's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that has informed us regarding this. And this principle was the way that the Salaf were. What I'm saying to you now, I extrapolated from the statement of Hassan al-Basri. كان الحسن البصري رحمه الله تعالى إذا تلا هذه الآية فلا تغرنكم الحياة الدنيا ولا يغرنكم بالله الغرور. Hassan al-Basri, when he would recite this verse, he said, and do not let this world deceive you. Reciting the verse of Allah. Allah saying, do not let the life of this world deceive you. And then he would say, and the chief of deceivers, that shaitan, do not let him deceive you. And after reciting this, then listen to what Hassan al-Basri, he would say, man qala dha, who is saying this? قَالَ مَنْ خَلَقَهَا وَهُوَ أَعْظَمُ بِهَا. The one that is saying this is the one that has created the dunya. And he is most knowledgeable regarding his creation. It is Allah that is telling us, do not let this dunya deceive you. وَعَنْ أَبِي دَرْدَاءِ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَلَىٰ عَنْهُ قَالَ خَرَجَ عَلَيْنَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ وَنَحْنُ نَذْكُرُ الْفَقَرُ وَنَتَخَوَّفُهُ. Abu Darda, he says that on occasion we were sitting, the companions, and we were thinking about poverty. And amongst our discussion, we feared poverty. And then the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he came out and he heard this. And then he said, Al-faqru takhafoon. Is it poverty that you fear? And then he said, وَالَّذِي نَفْسِ بِيَدِهِ لَتُسَبَّنَّ عَلَيْكُمُ الدُّنْيَا سَبَّا حتى لا يزيغ قلب أحدكم إزاغة إلا هي. He said, by the one whom my soul is in his hands, that there will come a time that the dunya and the riches of the dunya will be opened up to you, vast riches, and it will deviate your hearts. It is the things of the dunya that will be opened up to you that will deviate your hearts. وَفِي رِوَايَةٍ قَالْ فَوَاللَّهِ مَا الْفَخْرُ أَخْشَى عَلَيْكُمْ. He said, by Allah, it is not poverty that I fear for you. But he said, وَلَكِنَّنِي أَخْشَى أَنَّ تُبْسِدَ الدُّنْيَا عَلَيْكُمْ كَمَا بُسِتَتْ عَلَى مَنْ كَانَ قَبْلَكُمْ فَتَنَافَسُوهَا كَمَا تَنَافَسُوهَا فَتُهْلِكَكُمْ كَمَا أَهْلَكَتْ هُمْ. رواه ترمذي. He said, but rather what I fear, that the riches of this world will open up for you, and then you will begin to compete. You will compete for these riches, and it would destroy you like he destroyed those before you. Listen to what Allah and the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling us. قال الله عز وجل وما الحياة الدنيا إلا متاع الغرور. And what is the life of this world except for a passing enjoyment? This is what Allah is describing this world. وعن أبي سعيد الخدري رضي الله تعالى عنه قال عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال الدنيا حلوة وخضرة. The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said that the life of this world, look at the description. The Messenger said that the life of this world is sweet and green. What does he mean by sweet and green? That the shaitan makes it sweet for you. He adorns it for you, fools you regarding it. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will establish upon the earth generations and generations. فَيَنْذُرُ مَا تَعْمَلُونَ. Then Allah azza wa jal will see what you do amongst your life in this dunya. فَاتَّقُوا الدُّنْيَا was the nasiha of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So therefore, fear the dunya. Are we still doubting? This is the reality of the place that we live in. قال الله عز وجل كل متاع الدنيا قليل والآخرة خير لمن اتقى. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says that the enjoyment of this world, it is very little. It is little, but the akhirah, it is better for you. It is better for you. فَاتَّقُوا الدُّنْيَا أَنْصَحَ النَّفْسِي وَأَنْتُمْ كَذَلِكَ. I advise myself and my brothers and my sisters, let's wake up to the words of Allah Azza wa Jalla. As Hassan al-Basri said, who is the one that is telling us this? Ponder upon that fact. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَاتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمْ فَإِنَّ دُنْيَاكُمْ فَانِيَا. Fear Allah, for this dunya will perish away. The only thing that you take with you is your righteous actions and what you did in khala, fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as for the one that is drowned and blinded by this dunya, فقال الله عز وجل فأما من تغى فآثر الحياة الدنيا فإن الجهيم هي المأوى. And as for the one who transgresses the limits of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you choose this life over the hereafter, then know your abode will be the hellfire. The words of my Lord and your Lord, the words of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We need to reflect how the Salaf reflected. The Salaf were better than me and you. And upon hearing this, look at the mindset that they had. قال سفيان الثوري رحمه الله تعالى إن الدنيا بحر عميق. Listen to this, that verily this world is a deep ocean. فقد غرق ناس كثير. And this dunya has caused many to drown. It is a deep and fitna. It is a deep ocean, and many have drowned. And then listen to the nasir that he said, فَلْتَكُونْ سَفِينَتَكْ فِيهَا. So then let your ship that you have, that will sail in this fitna and this deep ocean of fitna and dunya, let your ship be the taqwa of Allah Azza wa Jal. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put that taqwa in our hearts, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. أَقُولِ قَوْلِ هَذَا أَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له إقرارا به وتوحيدا وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم تسليما مزيدا. قال الله عز وجل ولا تتبعوا خطوات الشيطان إنه لكم عدو مبين. That shaitan, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has described, don't follow his footsteps. He is an open enemy to us. And it is he that will make this dunya seem green and beautiful. It is he that will blind you. It is he that will whisper for you to chase the dunya and the wealth of this dunya. But it is upon us to reflect the words of Allah and remember the words. He wants you to forget the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah azza wa jal, he says, Ya ayyuha an-nas ittaqoo rabbakum inna zalzalat as-sa'ati shay'un 'azeem. O mankind, fear the quake. Fear the earthquake of the hour is something 'azeem. Shaitan wants you to forget that. فَاتُّكُوا يَوْمًا تُرْجَعُونَ إِلَى اللَّهِ. Fear Allah. Fear a day that you will return back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He wants you to forget this. He wants you to forget that day. يَوْمَ يَكُومُ النَّاسُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. That day when every one of us will stand in front of Allah. He wants you to forget that. Listen to what the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to describe that day. وعن عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها قالت قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يحشر الناس يوم القيامة حفاة عراة غرلا. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that mankind will be resurrected on that day of judgment barefooted, naked, uncircumcised. And when Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha heard this, the first thought that came to her, naked, mankind, naked, men and women together. So she said, Ya Rasulullah, An-Nisa wal-Rijal, Jami'an, O Messenger of Allah, both men and women will be raised together naked. Ala yanzuru ba'duhum ila ba'd. Will they not be looking at each other? And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Ya Aisha, al-amru wa shaddu an yandhuru ba'dahum ila ba'd. Rawahu Muslim. He said, O Aisha, the fear will be far greater than looking at each other's private parts and worrying about being naked. That day will be far more heavier. Just ponder upon that. That if we were naked, what state we would be here? We want no one to see us. But on that day, you won't even care if you're naked. That is the reality of that day that shaitan wants you to forget. قال الله عز وجل يوم يفر المرء من أخيه وأمه وأبيه وصاحبته وبنيه. That day, a person will run from his brother, from his mother, and from his father, from his wife and his children. If any harm tries to come to our wife or our children today or our grandchildren, we give our lives to protect them. We let harm come to us first. But on that day, you won't even care about the loved ones. And it may be those loved ones that are taking you from the dhikr of Allah Azza wa Jal. But my point is, look at that day. That day is azim. when even your loved one, your child, that baby that you have, that you won't even care about it, that mother that you love, you won't even care. And the Shaykh Uthaymeen, he says, why? Mukhafatan, fearing that they may come and seek some rights from you and some ajr. That day it's nafsi, nafsi. So we need to prepare for that day. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Ad-dunya sijnul mu'min wal jannatul kafir. It ain't gonna be easy, as the Messenger, he said, that the reality of this life, that it is a prison for the believers, because we can't do this and we can't do that. We're restricted. And as for the kuffar, it is their jannah. Lakin akhirah khairul lana. The akhirah is better for us. It is difficult here, as Tawus ibn Kaysan rahimullah ta'ala, he said, حلو الدنيا مر الآخرة. The sweetness of this life, it will be bitterness in the akhirah. And then he said, الحلو الآخرة مر الدنيا. But the sweetness of the akhirah is bitter here, because it is difficult. And we pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keeps us firm. And I leave you with this final statement, azim, of Yahya ibn Mu'adh rahimullah ta'ala. He said, Ad-dunya khamaru shaitan. He said, the life of this world, it is the intoxicant of the shaitan. Man sakhara minha fala yufik illa fi asakhir al-mawta nadiman min al-khasirin. That this dunya is the intoxicant of the shaitan. Whoever drinks from it, whoever is intoxicated, then he will not regain consciousness up until he will be amongst the rank of the dead. Too late. And then he will be raised in a state where he will be remorseful and amongst the losers. May Allah Azza wa Jal put that fear in our heart. May Allah Azza wa Jal bless us with that taqwa of Allah Azza wa Jal. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raise us on a day where we'll be from those on the shade of Allah Azza wa Jal. May Allah Azza wa Jal raise us from those who will have that satr of Allah Azza wa Jal, and from those that Allah will bestow His mercy upon. Ameen. أقول قولي هذا استغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم أقيم الصلاة يرحمكم الله.